Welcome everybody to the StarCraft 2 SSL here. Welcome, welcome. We're having some audio issues, but we're going to jump right into it. How are you doing, Wolf?
I'm doing just fine. I feel like my voice sounds like when I played Rebel Assault 2 and the Corellian fighter was like cutting out and stuff, but I'm sure the issues will be resolved shortly, guys. We've been working on it for the past 20 minutes or so please bear with us if you can get the message out there to everyone that we are solving the problem. Please do. But this is going to be the first finals here of the year in Korea.
And it's going to be a big one. Stark, or rather Dark, known as one of the best players, if not the best player, is on a roll. Stats himself, it's his first finals for Dark 2 in a big, big Star League, a major one here.
Looking at the win rates, you can see Dark has had a much more, a much stronger performance at 10-1, whereas Stats actually having a negative win rate of 7-9 overall.
Yeah, Dark's road over here was a lot cleaner, and Stats had to go through that loser's bracket, and that's exactly why we say this finals is the two roads, right? The two roads to get here. Dark is on that high road, he's winning everything, only dropping one map, and then of course Stats having a bit of a rougher time, but he's fought his way through, and after 8 years, he's finally made it to a championship.
Yeah, that's right. Now looking at the roads here, breaking them down a little bit easier, the only loss Stats had, the player that knocked him into the loser bracket, was none other than Dark himself. He lost 0-3 to Dark in that winner's semis, and it was all about drop play, just all-ins, timing attacks. Dark just had his number on all three maps.
We were re-watching those maps, and we were hoping to learn something, but all we got was like three all-ins out of Dark. The third map was a little bit, you know, longer of a map. It was on Olrena, but it started off with an all-in from Dark again. So that was the only time, well, he did win against Classic there, but playing against Stats, it seems like his answer for dealing with Stats, who is also a very strong macro Protoss, is to just go aggression all the way here.
Yep, that is the way of things. Not sure what we're going to jump into here in just a moment. It might be us, our beautiful faces.
Finally, here we are, up on the second floor. We got the beautiful stage behind this. Welcome, everybody. I hope you can hear us and see us, because we finally seem to have gotten some of the issues fixed, and we're finally here at the beginning of the broadcast. That's good.
That's right. I think you guys can hear us, but we can't hear each other as well, so forgive us if we talk over each other or do just any sort of awkward like mistakes on our broadcast, because we have some issues there. Are they fixed? I think they literally just...
It's getting there.
It's almost fixed.
Yeah,
like it's
getting
there. We're working on it. But anyway, don't let our issues and our whatever we just mentioned mess up your hype for the finals. Get out there, tweet the link. I know there's even a big Blizzard post that has all the information except they spelled your name wrong. All in one convenient location.
It's okay. It's okay. I'm Brandon Valdez for today. That's totally fine.
That's
I'm just
totally
happy
okay.
to be here, Wolf. Up on the stage, well, up here on the balcony, casting for you guys in front of the stage.
Yeah, this is actually definitely our most dangerous casting setup we've had before. Like, literally, if
just
I lean back
it
in my
that
chair,
much more exciting, Wolf.
It would be fatal. Know? Yeah, so we can't jump up and down, or it could cause dangerous things to occur. But this finals that we have finally come to is kind of the culmination of 3 months of time for all these pro gamers. There were two roads, the loser bracket, the winner's bracket. Stats making it almost all the way to the end of the winner's bracket, losing to Dark, but he has his chance for redemption here. And this is the first big finals for both players, for an individual league, for a Star League.
Yeah, they both won it, and not for different reasons, but they've also kind of come through two different roads to get here. Dark, you know, the newer player, you know, hand-selected by Boxer, picked into Slayers, makes it into SKT, and is now doing fantastically. Finally, like, all that potential came to a head, and he finally hit that mark, right? Whereas Stats, he's been kind of getting by for 8 years, you know? He does fantastically in Pro League. Over the past 2 years, he's really made a name for himself. He used to be very underrated, but now he's a household name for anyone who knows StarCraft. And today he wants that championship after 8 years. He really, really wants it.
And that is the main story here, you know? For Stats, he's been playing the game much longer than Dark. He's been around much longer. He's been playing since Brood War. Pro League is his home. And he's famous for being that guy who could take all these best of ones. He carries KT a lot of the time. This, you know, pass around him and Zest together brought them, of course, very, very far, all the way to the playoffs there. But You know, does he want to be known forever as the player who carries pro leagues, wins best of ones? No, he wants people to know him as I am a StarCraft II champion.
Yeah, and he's finally made it here onto this grand stage. We've had another tournament here before. I think it was Rain versus Silky.
Yeah.
Back in the day, I think that was 2013.
Yeah, 2013
or 14. I believe it was. I remember just coming down myself as a fan. You know, I came with you guys here. I think Justin was here, former caster of Pro League. We all just watched and enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was the Hot Six.
I think we're casting that one.
Yeah, it's the Hot Six last big match that we had here in this very venue. So a lot of PBZ history of finals here. But this one, much more important. Now let's check out these maps. These maps that we're taking a look at right now are maps that many pro gamers are saying Zerg favorite in this matchup. But taking a look at the win rates, I mean, look at Dark. He's played so many more games in general in some of these maps. He's 7-1 on Lairlak Crest. That is an incredible stat.
That's pretty unbelievable, and there's no map like that for stats. I mean, he's 5-2 on Dust Towers. I'd say that's probably his best map. That's one of those maps where it does seem a little bit Protoss favored, so it's interesting the way that the map list is kind of formed here, because we go into Prion Terraces, definitely a very good Zerg map. Dark loves to pick, he probably picked that first. I wouldn't even doubt that Stats picks Dust Towers here as his first map, and it kind of just all bunches together. And we go into Arena, Orbital Shipyard, Central Protocol, Lairlak Crest, Runes of Saris to end it.
And because this is a best of seven, this is a grand finals, there are no map vetoes, no bans here. You have to play if the games go to game seven, all seven maps. So every single map is important. And as we see it, one or two players, whichever player takes the advantage will have to, you know, keep in mind what maps are coming next, which builds and which strategies they want to play. There are some strategies that are viable on multiple maps. So you have a map like Arena, though, where, you know, you have unique strategies that only work on that map.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty crazy, guys. We're almost ready to get to set number one. You can see the looks on both of these players' faces, nerves, excitement. They're ready to go, but they're on the biggest stage of them all here at one of the biggest Star Leagues in Korea. The map is loading up, Wolf. I think we're going to get into this in just a minute.
That we are. All right, guys, spread the word about this tournament. We're going to jump into game number one here on Prion Terraces.
Here we go, the first map of Dark versus Stats. Down here in the bottom right, the red Zerg from SK Telecom T1. It is Dark.
There's a shot of him. Very confident here, the big favorite in this best of seven. There's a fan for him right there, holding up his sign. And his opponent to the top in blue for KT Roaster. It is Stats. A lot of Stats fans here in this grand hall tonight.
The whole right side of the auditorium is filled with KT Stats fans. The two teams, by the way, of both of the players are down here watching. Nearly every player is there. You can look down. I saw Sue earlier. I saw Lucira over on KT's side. They're all in a line, so they've come to support their players here, their teammates.
Stats will get an early scout off here of what Dark is up to. Prion Terrace is a map that Zergs feel very comfortable on in this matchup. And just simply because of the way that gold bases work on this map, you know, you have more production power, you don't have to use as much larva on drones as the Zerg. So all things to keep in mind here. The third base is already coming up. Stats will go and scout this. Now in this brief early game, I do want everyone to get out there and spread the word. My Twitter is ProxyWolf. I just tweeted the new YouTube link because I know there was a problem with the old one. There's a new link. Go please retweet that. Tell everyone about this. We're on Ding It. We're on YouTube. I know we're not on what you guys, a lot of you guys expect to watch StarCraft on, well, this platform, but who cares? It's the finals. You better watch it. Whether we're watching this on your old grandma's TV, it doesn't matter. You gotta watch. The Star League Finals, okay?
Exactly. You have to get out there and watch it. I know you guys who are listening, you're already watching, but you got to tell people who could be listening to get out there, post it on Twitter, go, you know, on all the other social media outlets you have. Just make sure people are watching this because it is going to be very epic. Stats, you know, definitely the underdog coming into this one. Nearly every single person I've talked to saying Dark is the favorite. But I mean, Stats, he's, again, we say in 8 years, it's been a long time. He's going to be fighting hard for this one.
Yeah, and most people are going as far to say, I'm talking to the Korean commentators, some of the pro gamers here, production people, most people are saying they think Dark will take it 4-0, that he will not drop a single map. The SKT coach, Oof, joked earlier that he was going to win it 7-0. He was going to crush it.
He went that far. It may have even been a little bit far, but...
These two gateways are shown directly to Dark here underneath the Overlord. Obviously adding gateways to the stage of the game, nothing too crazy about that. It's not like you need to hide that information. Dark continually checking. Oh. We're going to see Baneling Ness and Baneling Drop coming in. This is how Dark played that previous series versus Stats. It was drops almost every game.
Yeah, and we've been seeing this a lot more often in ZVP, even with the Stargate out on the map. It looks like, you know, Oracle's going to be the choice here, but Rogue doing it against Zets when there were like four Phoenixes out on the map. If you can get those Baneling drops into the bag, you can do so much damage, especially on two base for the Protoss. So, already getting that Overlord speed, getting that full scout of the base, sees everything, knows what the tech is of Stats, and will definitely commit to this.
Setting up for those Overlords right now as Lings go out. Arobo on the way for Stats. He did commit to two Oracles. Already getting grabbed some drones here, just ignoring the score. The Queen's not in position, so two free drone kills there. And Overlord over here following the Mothership Core. He wants to know where it is at all times. We might see some Balings morph here. Four over here on the right side. The Overlord is ready as well.
Looks like he wants to pressure the third base at the same time. He's going to draw the attention of Stats to the third base. And the Baneling drop is going to come in the back door into the main.
But Stats is ready for this. He has spotter pylons in position as well as some adepts. But he needs to split his probes here. One Phoenix is coming out as well, which should help this. Okay, he's looking right here, right now. He just made these structures. Here comes the drop.
Drop coming in. Nothing moving. The probes are not getting out of the way. And here come the Banelings dropping them down.
Oh, the Banelings prioritizing the adepts. Very lucky for Stats. Very lucky. That could have been disastrous, but there's still two Banelings left. This isn't over yet.
Not over yet, and it looks like some damage on the other side too, but here come the Banelings. Nice splits, but good pickup by Dark. He does not waste those Banelings. Wants a better hit.
Oh, canceling that detonation, so smart. We'll get six probes in total here. And that's the end for this Drovalor, but two more morphing currently. Zatch's Oracles, looks like they got five kills maybe between the two of them. That's not a ton of damage, and this attack will continue. Most important thing for Stats, though, is he kept his third base up. That pressure, you know, that it was putting on there distracted him a little bit, but he keeps that third base alive. Oh, Stasis over here planted will stop one drone from mining.
Trying to get a bit tricky over there. Stats doesn't want that damage, so just trying to put down the Stasis ward. And look at the drone count right now of Dark. Of course, we talked about it before, he can stay low on drones just because of the way this map works with the two golds. But he also wants to put on the aggression. He does not want to let Stats get that free third base. And here he comes. Lots of queens already loaded up. Eight queens have been made, a total of 55 plagues. And here come the mains.
Here we go. We've seen this before. This has worked for Dark in the past. Here comes some Oracles. He can actually start targeting down these Banelings early if he wants to. Maybe he wants to build the energy.
Well, looks like he's going to wait. I'm not sure what he's waiting for. Maybe waiting for them to morph.
Okay, here we go. Don't forget there are Banelings in these Overlords as well. But I love this, he's gonna target down. Queen's coming in now to help deal with these Oracles. He kept it as a surprise. One Oracle about to go down, and down it goes. The second one will die as well. He needs force fields for life. Where are they?
No force fields, and the overcharge is coming down, but the Banelings are rolling through, and everything gets around, and there's still so much dirt left over.
Oh, this is disastrous here. Don't forget all the extra tweets. Stats getting bopped here in this first game. That third base is history.
Third base is totally going down, but can he stop some further damage from getting here? There is another Oracle on the map, but here comes some more Banelings.
Oh, here come the Banes right here into the second base of natural. He's not even dropping them. There's a queen in this as well, mind you.
He's just like threatening, and here we go, finally dropping them out. Here comes the queen. A Warpin should be able to defend, but again, no third base. Dark has taken a fourth.
All right, well, Stats lives for now, but for how long is that going to be the case? He's got a sentry, just one, I think. Just got one more warped, so maybe he's got two. Blink, okay, nope, just one. Blink is almost done. He's got plus one attack, but how long can he hold on? You know, how much more of this abuse can he really take? He's got a disruptor on the way, his very first. But I don't think it's going to be enough. Here we go. He moves out.
Stats trying to poke right now. He knows that Dark has committed a lot to this. He's not going to leave the game right now. Wants to do some extra harass damage with that Oracle that he still has up here. Dark going to continue with the drops into the main. He wants to bring this army out of position and find a way into Stats' base.
Looks like Stats isn't paying attention. So many probes could go down here. No move. One set of Baneling hits there. Still got three left. He needs to drop these out, actually. Does get a few more.
Not the best hits overall. So it does get cleaned up, but again, Stats can't really afford to be taking too much damage. Look at this, Queens are going to be dropping creep tumors here right outside the base, gonna make it harder even for Stats to get out of here.
Yeah, that right there is going to be an expansion of creep that will be so difficult to defend, especially if he brings Overseers over with these Queens. Looks like the Queens are just gonna walk back home, and Dark is gonna try to play a longer game from here. He still has his third base totally controlled. His only fear, I'd say, is actually the follow-up attack with Disruptors, Blinkstalkers, and plus two. You know, that this army is getting pretty big, and if he does good force fields versus the Banes, they won't be able to connect. He only has one sentry, though, mind you, at this point in time.
Yeah, just one sentry. I mean, but look back at the base of Dark. Four bases. He's droning up a bit now. He's not overdroning, by the way. He's still going with this Link Bane style for now. Just Link Bane Muta, or not Muta, Queens here. Nine Queens still out on the map. Looks like Stat's going to try to break out of his base with a drop with the Warp Prism. This does get spotted, but how will Dark respond?
Well, let's see how quickly he reacts to this. He may not expect there to be a Disruptor in this. May be able to target it down before it can get the shot off, though.
Could try to drop it here. Nope, not going to commit. Just waiting for the right time, right place.
Looking for a much better opportunity. Big lane counterattack. Going to grab a sentry at the very least here. And it's going to confirm that there's still no third base, nor, you know, at neither location. Just now he started that third nexus again.
Look at that drop back there doing no damage. Kind of just floating in this space behind the bases. He wants to find a place to drop, but he just is not confident enough to do it.
He can't escape either. Looks like he's drawing some of these units back so he can come up here and attack. These Banelings over here, they have speed, but they're isolated. And Link is ready on these Stalkers. So many Links here. What am I watching? I mean, this meta for this matchup has changed into Ling Baneling versus Stats.
Dark trying to redo it here, but here comes the surround. The force fields need to be perfect, and they are.
With
really
good
nice
force fields, you know, this isn't a very good comp versus what Stats has. Stats has 70 army supply to 90. With good force fields, a lot of this army is useless.
Oh, that was so close. That Zealot just barely gets put on hold. Command there by Stats. Does save the majority of his base with that hole.
There are 104 links on the map, but there are disruptors and sentries. It's going to be hard to hit with all these melee units. Where are the force shields? They need to come down. Here they come.
Force shields come down, but the links are in.
And the Baneling drops are coming in as well.
Here come the Baneling drops. Their stop wants to drop and left. The disruptor will get one hit, but there goes everything that Stats ever owned.
That is looking pretty rough to defend. I mean, even if you get the perfect post for donut, force field donuts, if Overlord drops come on top with speed, you can just drop in the center of that donut and end the game that way.
Overseer over here to see the DTs and the Zealots and the Stalkers. There's not much left of them. Stats will definitely lose this base. GG! Dark takes Brian Terrace's game number one.
Dark plays Link Baneling. This matchup, he's not messing around with it. He starts with the drops. He makes it his main unit composition. We saw it in his previous EVPs. We're seeing it here again. We've seen it in Pro League. This is how he plays the matchup right now.
Yeah, and it makes sense to do it on that map too. You get all that extra larva. You can't go for harass such as that. You keep the Protoss on two base for so long. It's a decently large map to the point where you can get that fourth base if you're putting on enough aggression. You can see the KG coach is like, yeah, that was Prime Terrace's. Whatever, Dark. Whatever.
Prior Terrace is a very Zerg-centric map. We see Zergs on it all the time. We even see a lot of ZBZs in Pro League as a result. And Dark will take the momentum here. I always love to talk about this, though. When you have a best of seven, four grand finals, the player that wins the first game has like a 79% win rate. It just means, it shows you that the momentum goes to the first player a lot of the time.
Yeah, and I mean, a lot of StarCraft is nerves. Well, not so much nerves, psychology, right? You're coming into this, you're on stage. It's different. It's the reason why you could be the best practice player in the world, but you will never do well on stage if you don't deal with some of that psychology involved in StarCraft. So